Welcome to Unity of Wilmington's Christmas Eve candlelight service. Thank you for being with us from all around the world, from our hearts to your hearts. We are one in spirit. We are joined in the celebration of the holiday story, the myriad of festivals of light celebrated by so many different religions and traditions. Very grateful to be one with you in this now moment. So let's begin with a time of prayer. I'll keep my eyes open, but I'm asking you to pray in the way that's most comfortable and feels most right to you. Turning inward to that light that you are, to that inner knowing of your oneness with God, that inner knowing that there's only one presence and one power active in the universe and in our lives. Presence and power we call God. In this oneness with God, we remember our wholeness. We remember our spiritual pattern of perfection. We draw upon our hope and our faith. We feel peace. We feel that generative, harmonizing power of love and that bubble of joy. For all of this and more, we say thank you, God, and amen. We will light candles this Christmas. Candles of joy, despite all sadness. Candle of hope, where despair keeps watch. Candles of courage for fears ever present. Candles of peace for tempest-tossed days. Candles of grace to ease heavy burdens. Candles of love to inspire all of our living. Candles that will burn all year long. Ooh.
Why so scared that you'll mess it up when perfection leaves you haunted? All we need is your best, my love, that's all anyone ever wanted. Love is how we do, let no judgment overrule it. Love, I look to you and I say,
Christmas Eve. We're at the very heart of Christmas tonight. This is what we're celebrating, the heart of Christmas, the light that shines from within us, that opens our heart, that opens our minds. And then as we bring our hearts and our minds together, it is this light, and it is the love that comes from our heart that we stand in, radiating forth, making a difference in the world. The heart brings a level of knowing that is beyond the mind. The heart brings us into experience, and from that experience, we can move into understanding. We can move into knowingness, and we can move into action. From the mind to the heart. And sometimes this journey from the mind to the heart is the most difficult journey. I can think about love. I can desire love. I can think about being loving. But until I bring the thought into the heart, and then from the heart take the action, I don't have the experience. And so we are being called, particularly this year, where Christmas is different than it's ever been before. But if we honestly sort of widen our perspective, what we will discover is every Christmas is different. This Christmas just happens to be bold and italicized with its differences. It's a call to recognize, to become aware of where we are in life and where we want to be going. It's a time that we've been invited to take self-reflection and make decisions. We're always at that place. We always have that ability to self-reflect and make a decision. But this year, more than any year, it is within our awareness. It is within the differences that we have encountered throughout this year that are calling us to look, to be present, to see what is before us. And then, from that seeing, to step into beingness. Who do we want to be? Who do we want to be from this moment forward? So often we talk about the Christmas story on Christmas Eve. It's often that we read it. The story comes from two places in the Bible. It comes from the book of Matthew and the book of Luke, and they're very different. And so often when we hear the Christmas story, what's happened is somebody has blended those stories. But even with the differences where there's wise men, there's angels, there's a star of Bethlehem in one and not in another, the Magi come much later. Even with those differences, what is the heart, at the heart of the Christmas story, is that we are inherently divine. We are inherently divine. Inherently means we're so woven into that the divinity is woven into the tapestry of our humanity, that it's inseparable. And what the universal teacher, Jesus, came into being to remind us is of that divinity, of that inherent divinity where in oneness we are one with God. That in our oneness we are not separate from each other. And I believe this year, more than any year, we have been called over and over to be able to connect in our hearts. At times we cannot connect physically. We're being called to connect in our hearts in times where it seems impossible. We're being called to connect in our hearts, to learn to come to this visible center. The heart is a visible center of this invisible expression of love. It is from the heart that we give and receive love. This is not new to any of us. It's a reminder on this sacred night of who we are. It's a weaving together of that humanity and the divinity that we are. And we're reminded that we have a choice in all moments. Will we live from our hearts, or will we live as if we're not connected? There's a beautiful Christmas movie. Somebody said to me, hey, you need to watch this movie. It's called The Christmas Candle. It was filmed in 2013. It's a British movie. It was filmed in this imaginary town called Gladsbury. And every 25 years in this town, the Christmas angel comes and lays hands on a candle. And that candle then is given to somebody. The recipients or the townspeople write the request, and somebody pulls the request out of a basket, and then that candle is given to that person whose request is being honored. And the idea of the movie is you light the candle and you pray. You light the candle and you stand or sit in front of the candle and you pray. So there's a new minister in this town, and he begins to invite the people to shift their culture. When we look at praying to a candle, and we're not recognizing that the light that is that candle is actually reflected in our hearts, then we're actually separate, feeling ourselves. We're never really separate, but we feel ourselves as separate. And he was changing a culture to invite the people of the town to recognize that they were not separate from each other. To recognize it was not the power in the candle, but actually the power in their hearts. And then when we open our hearts to transformation, to evolution, and begin to recognize that we are one, then transformation is happening. And when I look at you and I see you, I'm also seeing myself. I'm seeing a reflection of me, but I'm also seeing a reflection of your divinity, your inherent divinity, your inseparable divinity. And when I stand in that consciousness of my own divinity, when I recognize that I am light, then I can see you as light. This was the message that the teacher Jesus came to share with us. Why was Jesus born in a stable? Metaphysically, the stable is that interweaving of our divinity and our humanity. Imagine what your life would be like if you were traveling, that you had been called to travel by the government and you were traveling, and where you came to, there was no room for you. How often do we have that experience in consciousness now? We walk into a room and we start to talk to people, but inside ourselves we feel like there's no room for us in that place. Think about what it feels like, the sadness, the hurt, the pain that it feels like. And yet what is true is we are welcome on this planet. We are welcome wherever we are. We are welcome in the light that we are. We are welcome as we shine our light. For as we shine our light, as we're opening our hearts, what we're discovering in the opening is that the more we love, the more we embody love. And the more we embody love, the more we're the invitation to change in the world. The more we embody love, then we are going to see the world differently. The world may not change, but we are going to see the world differently. We are being called to see it differently, just like the town of Gladsbury was being called in this movie, called to recognize it's not something outside ourselves that is changing us, but it's moving into our heart space. It's moving from the head to the heart and then opening the heart. And from opening the heart, taking the action. What began to happen in the movie was while people still believed that it was the candle to some degree, they begin to assist each other. Somebody's roof needed fixing. Somebody's fence needed mending. There was a young boy who was having some difficulty in speaking. And what began to happen is as people's hearts began to open, they begin to reach out to assist. They begin reaching out to help. They begin reaching out, lending support too. They came out of the bubble of their own world and their own perception, widened their worldview, and began to see each other in their divinity. Now, part of what happened in this story, and I'm going to ruin the movie for you if you go back and watch it, but part of what happened is the people who the angel would come to and touch the candle, they had a little mishap, and all the candles rolled away, and they didn't know actually which candle was the right candle. So they made this decision. They made a decision to give a candle to everybody who'd made a request. But they didn't tell anybody else. So they went to each person and said, "We're honoring your request, and here is the Christmas candle. Light it and pray. Light it and pray." And what happened? Unbeknownst to anybody that other people had that candle, they lit the candle and they prayed, and their hearts opened. This is the Christmas story. It's never outside of us. It's always inside of us. The light that we're celebrating tonight and every night is always burning within us. The question is, are we seeing the reflection within us and then seeing the reflection outside of us? Are we allowing our light to shine brightly? Are we making the kinds of choices that when we notice that our mind is thinking something that is not kind, something that is hurtful, are we able to notice that and shift our thinking and bring our thinking back to the heart of love, the heart of Christmas, the heart of the story of the teacher Jesus? The beautiful thing is that that story is universal. That story is our story as we embrace that story. And what I know is the moment that we begin to embrace transformation, we make choices in our living for transformation, then what begins to happen is what may seem like an ordinary life begins to feel extraordinary. We move on the continuum from ordinary to extraordinary. And the more we engage in activities that come from our open heart or that allow us to open our heart, we can begin step by step to embody love. We embody transformation, and little by little by little we become who we truly are, love. Now, for 25 years, Unity of Wilmington has engaged in a practice, a community service project. We call it the Lasagna Project. But what we do is we come together in the community, the spiritual community bakes lasagnas. And then those lasagnas are cut up and plated in a way that they can be carried to seniors, to people who otherwise would not have a Christmas Eve meal. This year, we put the call out for Christmas lasagnas. And one of the members of our community who could not be here in Wilmington took that call to Facebook, and she put the call out to the greater community. She moved from her heart into action. And then on Facebook, she put a GoFundMe type of thing, inviting others who couldn't be present in Wilmington to donate money for this cause, the Lasagna Project of Meals on Wheels. And this year, the person who headed up the project invited us to expand the project beyond Meals on Wheels and include the homeless. So early this morning, lasagnas begin to arrive to the doors of Unity of Wilmington. Over 50 lasagnas arrived, and they were cut up and they were placed with other food in a container, and then the Meals on Wheels people delivered the Meals on Wheels lasagnas, and then our project coordinator delivered the other lasagnas to the homeless, over 50 of them. Acts of service, acts of love, acts and the action of taking love from our hearts into the world. Acts of giving to someone, not because they are in need, but because they are a reflection of who we are, inherently divine. I stood on the sidewalk this morning, and tears welled up in me to see the people of this community who came and brought lasagnas. And it was exciting to see them. And tears welled up in me to see people I had no idea who they even were showing up at the steps of Unity of Wilmington with a hot lasagna at 8 a.m. Called into service by a person who put it on Facebook. Called into service by their own hearts who recognize that in giving, we are increasing the frequency of love on this planet. We are the miracle of Christmas. And when we begin to embrace that knowingness, that understanding of our transformation, when we begin to embody it with our action, we begin to live extraordinary lives. 25 years, this was the 26th year of service to people. And there were more this year because of circumstances and environmental conditions. There were more people who received the gift of love in action through a meal. It makes my heart sing because it's the recognition that that is the miracle of Christmas. That as we live together, as we move together, and as we have that understanding of our beingness as divine, and begin to be able to see each other in our divinity, our hearts open, and we begin to embody the message of the Christmas story, that we are one, one with God, or whatever name you use for God, and one with each other. And we are being called, especially at this time, this strange and wondrous year that we're living, to seek the good that is present, to learn new ways of being, to find ways to connect heart to heart, even when we may not be in physical presence with somebody, to find a way to be family, the kind of family that is a family that lives in the frequency of love, that lives from the consciousness of our divinity. That recognizing when we see something out there, what we can do is bring our love in here, into our heart center. Hold the love. Hold the love. And then from holding that consciousness of love, listen to our inner guidance, whatever it may be, and step forth and live it. And truly, be the light of the world. To truly be the light of the world. Metaphysically, light is spiritual intelligence and wisdom. To live from that. So that when a call to action comes forth, we tune in and see if we are one of the ones being called to take that action. But we can bring it to the personal. When we notice our critical thoughts, whether they're about ourselves or others, because sometimes, for some of us, our critical thoughts are more about ourselves than ever they are about another. But when we begin to notice those critical thoughts, we surround them in love, bringing them into our heart and loving ourselves for those moments and transforming the thought, which unfolds divine order into our lives. Because what we know is that when we come from love, we're living in what we call principle. We're living in love because love and principle are synonymous. We're living in love. And what we teach week after week after week here is that our thoughts held with feeling, a feeling like love or inspiration or harmony or peace or joy or faith, those thoughts held with feeling will produce more thoughts and feelings of their kind. And the more we are embodying love, the more we are going to live out that love moment by moment. The more we are going to be the light of the world. The moment we begin to see that, we begin to step forth as the miracle that we are, inherently divine, woven into the tapestry of our humanity, living as the light of the world that we are, choosing moment by moment to be love, choosing, a power that we hold in every moment is the power of choice. What choice will you make on this beautiful, sacred, and holy, meaning wholeness, this beautiful, sacred, and whole Christmas Eve?
Light all the candles, stand by the tree. There's no one awake at midnight but me. I slip down the hall, and amid the moonbeams, the kids are tucked in, dreaming Christmas dreams. Days of such wonder, magic filled nights, moments they'll look back on all of their lives. So much time wide-eyed at holiday scenes. Now they're worn out dreaming Christmas dreams. Dreams of cookies and cards, boxes and bows, storefronts and stockings, and days when it snows, with all of the secrets that this season keeps. It's a wonder at all that they fall asleep. Smile as I kiss them, 'cause under that tree are surprises that they're not expecting to see. We're just hours away from their giggles and screams, the answer to all their Christmas dreams. Of tinsel and toys in Santa's workshop, noises outside coming from the rooftop, with all of the secrets that the season keeps. It's a wonder at all that they fall asleep. The thought comes to mind that I may be the one who's most excited about what's yet to come. As I crawl in bed, I laugh 'cause it seems, guess you're never too old for Christmas. No, you're never too old for Christmas. You're never too old for Christmas dreams. Too old for Christmas dreams.
Let's spend some time together in meditation on this beautiful evening, or whenever you're watching this service. I'm going to keep my eyes open. You're welcome to keep your eyes open or closed, whatever works best for you. But as we begin to move into a time of meditation, I'm going to invite you to tune your breathing into your heart. If you can, do a count of six breaths in and six breaths out. If you cannot do six, do three or two, whatever works for you. But focusing on our breath for a moment, breathing into our heart will assist us in staying focused for a moment. So breathing into our heart space. and then letting that breath flow out. And see if you can make it a circle. So you're breathing in and breathing out without the pause. It's a simple circle of life, a circle of love, a circle of breath. And as you breathe, if you feel called to it, close your eyes. And quietly in your mind's eye, I invite you to say, I am inherently divine. I am inherently divine. And from this space of my divinity, with my attention and my focus on my heart, I focus my energy on the frequency, the energy of love. I focus my energy on love. You might say that in your mind's eye a little bit, a couple of times, whatever works for you. I focus my energy in love, in the energy of love. Holding that space in my heart open. Seeking first the consciousness of love. And then allowing that consciousness, that feeling of love, to begin to flow through your body. Maybe it follows the circle of your breath. Breathing love in and breathing love out. The circle of your breath, the circle of life, the circle of light. Allowing our love, our life, our light to expand throughout our bodies and radiate forth from us, as us. Radiate into this beautiful time on this planet. Uplifting. Inspiring love, so that wherever we go, wherever we walk, we are radiant love, bringing it with us as an invitation to all. They can choose to accept it or not, but we are the invitation. And as we love, as we realize that we are light, lighting up this world, being a light being, a light presence wherever we go, we are raising the frequency of this planet. We are reminders, whether it's conscious or unconscious, of our inherent divinity. Reminding ourselves and reminding all whose paths we cross in a nonverbal way. Being the model of love and light. Being the one who brings the highest frequency into whatever room that we are in. Being the one that recognizes that as we live as love, we are changing the cells, the very cellular matter of our bodies, raising our immune systems. But more than anything, we're seeing our oneness with each other. And from that oneness, we are interacting from that consciousness of love. The season of lights, whatever spiritual practice that you have. The season of love. The season of remembering who and what we are. The season of listening deeply to our own inner guidance and stepping forth in service with each other. A phone call. A letter, an email, a text that says, thank you for being you in my life. whatever it is, in whatever way that you reach out, know beyond a shadow of a doubt that that reaching out is raising the vibration of this planet, is healing, is peace, bringing us into harmony, bringing us joy, creating lives that move from the ordinary to the extraordinary. What choice will you make? What dream will you fuel from your consciousness of love? What gift will you become and be and live over this next year? How often are you willing to notice your judgment and criticism and bring it home to love, to be transformed? Because we are the Christmas miracle. The miracle is you, and the miracle is me. And we stand in the consciousness of that miracle, and we live step by step, moment by moment. And when we forget, we invite ourselves to remember, to choose, and to step again as love. So allowing yourself to come back to this time and this place, this now moment, forever changed because you were willing to take a look. I invite you to allow that change to expand in time and space across this year in love.
In the shadows of the darkness, in the jagged edges of the breakings, in the searing explosion of the shattering, it is there, a strength, a power, a glory that is there with us always, silently unnoticed, yet pulsing with life. It is light. The light that we came from, the light that we go to, the light that we are. Enter then the flame inside you and warm yourself in the light. Unity of Wilmington has a tradition of candle lighting, and some of you may have come and collected a holiday service kit from us, and so you have a candle. You can pause this video and go get a candle and come back. But the candles that Unity of Wilmington gave out this year and every year always have an affirmation on them. And so if you have one of those, I invite you to take it off. It's a little rubber band. And if you would like Unity of Wilmington to send you your own personal affirmation, stick it in the chat. I will follow up on Facebook and message you one back.
Mine says, "Divine mind expresses itself through me as creative thoughts and action. Divine mind expresses itself through me, as creative thought and action."
Mine said, "You have greater clarity on your goals, and you have the strength to follow through on them." I really appreciated that strength part. But what we're going to do now is light the candle, and then Hannah will come back and sing Silent Night. We will end our time together that way. When I was growing up, we would say, "I light the light of Christ in me," as an outward expression of that light that is inherent in you. It's not something you get. It's something you have and have always had. community of Wilmington, to you. Merry Christmas. Have a silent night.